Welcome to Bellathor's General Goods. Welcome indeed.
I work for Bellathor. The General Goods Store.
This is a surprise.
Just stand still!
Know your worth.
Best you can do.
Lucky hit.
Enough! Are you prepared to die?
tell you what. You start running, or I can take you.
No. Not like this. You can take me. Finish this.
Thank you. 7,000 steps again, Clement?
Not today. I'm just not ready to make the climb to High Rock Guard. But that isn't safe.
Thank you. So, a dragonborn appears at this moment in the turning of the age. We will see if you truly have the gift. Show us, Dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice. Shout at us. Let us taste of your voice. I am Master Arngeir. I speak for the Greybeards. Now, tell me, Dragonborn, why have you come here? We are honored to welcome a Dragonborn to High Hrothgar. We will do our best to teach you how to use your gift in fulfillment of your destiny. That is for you to discover. We can show you the way, but not your destination. You have shown that you are Dragonborn. You have the inborn gift. But do you have the discipline and temperament to follow the path laid out for you? Remains to be seen. Without training, you have already taken the first steps towards projecting your voice into a thum, a shout. Now let us see if you are willing and able to learn. When you shout, you speak in the language of dragons. Thus, your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power. All shouts are made up of three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will now teach you Vro, the second word in Unrelenting Force. Vro means balance in the dragon tongue. Combine it with Fus, force, to focus your thumb more sharply. Vro. Dragonborn, you can absorb a slain dragon's life force and knowledge directly. As part of your initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding of Vro. use your unrelenting force shout to strike the targets as they appear. Use both weapons if you can. Use both words if you can. Use both Fus and Ro. Together they will make the shout more powerful. Use your unrelenting force shout to strike the targets as they appear. Well done. Again. Quickly. Once more. Use both Fus and Ro. Together they will make the shout more powerful. Track the targets as they appear. Impressive. Your thumb is precise. You show great promise, Dragonborn. We will perform your next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Bori. See how you learn a completely new shout. Master Bori will teach you Wuld, which means whirlwind. Wuld! You must hear the word within yourself before you can project it into a thum. Approach Master Bori and he will gift you his knowledge of Wuld. Thank you. Master Wolfgar will demonstrate whirlwind sprint. Then it will be your turn. Master Bari?
X!
Hold! Now, your turn. Stand next to me. Master Bari will open the gate. Use your whirlwind sprint to pass through before it closes. Is this your best effort? Again. Quick mastery of a new Thume is astonishing. I'd heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, but to see it for myself. You are now ready for your last trial. Retrieve the horn of Jürgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ustengrav. Remain true to the way of the voice, and you will return. He was a great war leader of the ancient Nord, the master of the voice, or tongue. After the disaster at Red Mountain, where the Nord army was annihilated, he spent many years pondering the meaning of that terrible defeat. He finally came to realize that the gods had punished the Nords for their arrogance and blasphemy. He was the first to understand that the voice should be used solely for the glory and worship of the gods, not the glory of Jürgen Windcaller's mastery of the voice eventually overcame all opposition and the way of the voice. The voice was a gift of the goddess Kinnereth at the dawn of time. She gave mortals the ability to speak as dragons do. Although this gift has often been misused, the only true use of the voice is for the worship and glory of the gods. True mastery of the voice can only be achieved when your inner spirit is in harmony with your outward actions. In the contemplation of the sky, Kinnereth's domain, and the practice of the voice, we strive to achieve this balance. That is commendable. But remember, the dragon blood is itself a gift of Akatosh. Do not try to deny that gift. Your destiny requires you to use your voice. Why else would Akatosh have bestowed this power upon you? If you remember to use your voice in service to the purpose of Akatosh, you will remain true to the way. Wind, guide you.